Hey, what's going on, guys? Welcome back to American Truck Simulator. My name is Moose78, and this is my ATS Let's Play series, Stories in the Road. Hope you guys are doing well today, and hopefully everyone had a great holiday season, had a great New Year's. We are here in Phoenix, Arizona today in the Kenworth T680, but you kind of notice there something's just a little bit different. If you guys caught the last couple gameplay videos, you guys probably already know. But this is a project I've been working on for about the last week or two. Actually, been working on it quite a bit longer than that. Robert and I actually started working on this back in the spring of last year. I think it was around June or so. And he helped me out with it quite a bit. This is the 2017 owner-operator spec. I really like the skirtless look on it. It just kind of goes with that kind of old-school look, I guess, you know, before all the aero trucks and stuff came out. But yet, it still got that newer, clean aero look to it. Got the two-piece light bar there on the back. Got a ton of stuff to do to this yet. When Robert sent it back to me, he added another chassis to it that's just a little bit longer wheelbase than this. I still want to do some stuff with that. I want to get some different fender options on here, some different light bar options, mud flap options, side skirt options, exhaust options, options. Just a ton of stuff to do yet. But I really like how it's turned out so far. And I'll be honest, when Kenworth first debuted this truck, I think it was May of last year, I was pretty skeptical. You know, I didn't know quite what to think about it, but over time, it has definitely grown on me, and I gotta say, this is probably, of the newer trucks out on the road today, this is probably one of my favorite ones out there. But let's go ahead and get it fired up here. Using Creech Bomb's newest sound pack, I think it's 2.4 if I'm not mistaken. A link for that will be down in the description. A link for the truck will not be because it is nowhere near done yet. But this is the N14 Select 610 horsepower shipped engine. Got an 18-speed Eaton Fuller with 355s in it. So this should do pretty well for us. But we got a load of cheese we got to go pick up down at Phoenix Freight. So let's go down, get the freight picked up, and that is going to Las Vegas. 40,000 pounds of cheese, so someone in Vegas has a hankering for cheese, I guess. Oh, the interior on this is up to date with 1.5. So the wheel telescopes, all that good stuff. Tilt, telescope. Man, this engine mod sounds amazing. Creech Bomb always does a top-notch job with his sounds, and this one definitely does not disappoint. I hate this turn because it's kind of a blind spot there. And I have got to get some other stuff updated as well. There's just red textures all over the place. I thought we were picking up there, but I guess not. Oh, that's right, we're going to Phoenix Freight. Derp, derp, derp. I was messing around with some other stuff earlier, and I had to pick up there, so. This is kind of a dangerous intersection. Don't remember that being that hairy before. I don't know. And and this thing just sounds awesome. This is probably, I'll tell you right now, this is probably my favorite sound mod by Creech Bomb so far. This just sounds really, really, really good. But yeah, really pleased with how this has turned out so far, like I said. And like I said, I got a ton of stuff to do. Eventually, I would like to get this released, but just gonna be a little bit yet because I want to make sure it's, you know, done right. And, you know, no issues and stuff like that. Don't want to release a broken mod to everyone, so it's gonna be a little while yet. Got some more stuff I want to do. Want to edit some stuff in the interior. Make that a little bit more realistic. Get a gear shift down here on the floor. Get a CB up there. And then just get as many options on here as possible. Nothing crazy or anything like that. But just get some options on here. That way you guys can spec it out to however you want. That is so stinking annoying. I do like how they got the clutch fixed though. That's pretty sweet. No, one of the guys was saying something about it in a multiplayer, and I really didn't notice it a whole lot then, but here the last couple days, I have definitely noticed the clutch is a lot better than it has been at any point in the game. Now, it seems like you guys have been liking the multiplayer stuff, so thank you for supporting that. I know I definitely enjoyed hanging out with the guys and logging some miles there on the multiplayer. That'll definitely be hopefully a regular part of the channel. Whoopsie. Oh, it sounds really good on the outside. Really good on the outside. Yeah, but I think I'm definitely gonna have a lot of fun using this truck. We'll kind of get into that here in a little bit, I guess. Kind of what I got planned for 2017. All that good stuff. I know I was talking a couple weeks back there about doing something with the 579, but I'm definitely going to go with this truck moving forward. And probably what I'm going to do is I'm probably going to drop down to fifth gear here. But probably what I'm going to do is I'll feature this truck in one episode of the Let's Play Stories from the Road. Then the next video that week, or if I do, you know, multiple videos that week, it'll likely be different trucks and stuff like that. But this is kind of going to be my go-to truck for one of the episodes. Kind of want to do some like role play stuff. We'll kind of get into that here in a little bit as we get the trailer picked up here and going down the highway. But probably after I get this truck completely done and everything, I'm probably going to start out a new profile. And then kind of incorporate some role play into Stories from the Road. Maybe rebrand it a little bit moving into 2017 here. Just kind of freshen it up, mix it up a little bit. Phoenix Freight. This is probably my favorite place to pick up and deliver to for sure. All right. There is the trailer they want us to take, but I want to take that one, or let's see what else there is. Definitely like that there are some skirtless options for the reefers here. That's pretty stinking sweet. I think all this is going to do is just go through all the various... Oh, no, it's going to go through everything. Okay. Saying that's... Okay, some more skirtless options. I think that is... So I'd like to find a skirtless option with that reefer unit on it, because that is pretty stinking awesome. But if not... Yeah, let's just go back and grab that one. Yeah. Drop it down low. I definitely wish there was more places like this in the game, and maybe there will be moving forward as we get new maps and so forth. Like Phoenix Freight here to pick up and deliver to, because like I said, this is by far my favorite place to pick up, deliver freight and everything to. Is that us? That is us. I'm also using the Sound Fixes pack again. I haven't used it for quite a while, but seen it out on the Steam Workshop there. Figured give it a go. You know, no real rhyme or reason why I took it out. Just, I don't know. Just took it out, but added it back. And gonna see how this does. I think one of the reasons, I guess, now that I remember, I was having some issues with a crash and stuff like that. I think back in one of the betas, and I just never put it back in. But got it back in today. And gonna see how that does. And I'm about a mile and a half off. Now, one thing I thought was really cool, I thought I was going to have to edit it there in Zmod, but didn't have to do anything. Bam, there the stacks are. So that's pretty cool. There we go. Bam! Get all coupled up there. Do our tug test. Good there. Hop outside, take a look at the truck here real quick. Actually, daggone it, there was something I was going to change. Actually, I'm going to do that here real quick. Alright guys, we are back, and what I did was I just changed out weather mods, the graphics mods, whatever you want to call them. I took out or deactivated the Peva weather mod and put in the realistic mod with the HDR mod out there, the Steam Workshop, and I was hoping it would fix the darkness issue when I'm in the exterior review, but unfortunately it did not. I think that is something to do with NVIDIA Inspector. I don't know. I'm going to have to dive into that and get that figured out. But that's all changed. Got my screenshot. I do like this. They have done quite a pretty good job with this mod, though. I will say that. Flares look a lot better. Looks like all the lights are working. That means it's time for us to get out here and get to working. Head to Viva Las Vegas. Mirrors look okay, I guess. And that's one thing I really like on this T680 are the side mirrors. Plenty big enough. Spot mirror is definitely big enough to see. So that's why I'd never run hood mirrors on this truck in particular. Because I mess around with the newly released Mac Pinnacle, that is out for download. If you guys haven't got that already, be sure to look out for that. But I'll do some content with that next week. A couple of you guys were asking about that. Seen Robert got that out right around Christmas, but I hadn't had a chance to take a look at it till today or yesterday. Oh man, I wish they would do something with this intersection here. Traffic light or something. There's the 5-0. Now is he gonna stop? Escalade stopping. That was a dick move indeed. At least the Escalade stopped. See, now it seems like it's normal brightness and everything, so I don't know. Get off the curb, jackalope. But I've definitely been modding a lot more the last week or so, and I gotta say, I have thoroughly enjoyed it. It's definitely something I want to keep up. I think I got about 20-something days left on my Z-Mod license, and I'm going to have to renew that. And one mod I forgot to reactivate was the longer yellow light mod. Luckily, we didn't get a ticket there. But that is updated for 1.5. And one thing I have noticed, it seems like a lot of people are starting to migrate over to the Steam Workshop, which is really cool. It's nice and convenient. And the Steam Workshop's been around for a while, but it just seems like here lately there's a lot of people kind of migrating over to it. Maybe that's just me, I don't know, but merge on over here. There we go. Thanks, buddy. Appreciate it. Yeah, you're gonna have to let me over. Grr. Well, maybe that's something they can address in a future update, but the merging has not gotten any better in 1.5, that's for sure. But back to what I was talking about a little bit ago there. What I want to do is, once I get this truck completely done, I want to create a new profile and then just kind of start from scratch with this truck. You know, have this be, you know, kind of my truck, if you will. And just kind of, you know, throw in some role play there, you know, do some owner-operator stuff. You know, hire some drivers, things like that. You know, take out some loans, pay off some equipment, you know, things like that. And just kind of start from scratch. But with that, kind of what I want to do is also edit some of the trailers to where I'll essentially have a trailer ownership, which I have not messed around with this yet, so this may or may not work. But if it's anything like it was back in the Holland days, I'm thinking I should be able to go in and edit some of the cargoes and edit some of the companies. That way, you know, pretty much all the cargoes that I would have in, say, a reefer would be available to pick up and deliver to all those companies. And that way I can use the same trailer with this truck in this particular, you know, weekly episode with this truck, with the Stories from the Road series. And then probably what I'll do is I'll probably title these videos, you know, Stories from the Road, and then when I do other Let's Play stuff with other trucks, it'll just be Let's Plays. So that way everyone kind of knows what's what. And but still some stuff I'm, you know, kicking around in my head, kind of see where it goes. But that's kind of what I'm thinking about early on here in 2017. But trailer ownership definitely continues to be a pretty hot topic within the community. I gotta say, so far I'm really impressed with the sound fixes pack. Add some nice little ambient sounds to the cabin and everything. So that's pretty cool. Kind of liven up the game world a little bit. Oh, shiitake mushrooms. You know, one thing, this thing is just eating up this hill. Dadgum. Yes, we do. Now, there's one thing I gotta get sorted out is the brake sensitivity. I don't know if there's a way or something in the death files that can separate it out, or has it separated out for, you know, trailer brakes and tractor brakes. But anytime I put on my trailer brakes, because I have my brake sensitivity set so high, damn thing nearly comes to a dead stop. But the reason why I have my trailer brakes set so high is because of the spacer in the pedals here on the G920. And the tractor brakes are perfect. I love where they're at. It's just I gotta find out some way to kinda nerf the trailer brakes a little bit. I loved how that thing winds up. That's just cool. But like me and the guys were talking there in the multiplayer episodes, we definitely think, and I definitely think, they have brought this game a long, long way. All right, what are you doing? What are you doing? Thought that guy was going to turn there for a second, but no. It's going to keep on going. You could think about it, but don't do it. Reduce speed ahead. What is this jackass doing? It's like he kept brake checking me or something. Thank you. kind of going back to kind of the role play thing and all that good stuff, you guys probably noticed that I put my own company logo there on the side of the truck. But you notice there on the side box, I have leased two Coladas, so it's not like I left KTI or anything like that. But, you know, originally that was kind of the intention, you know, when KTI was started, was that we were all leased, you know, KTI, but we owned our own trucks. So I'm kind of, I guess in that regard, I'm kind of going old school just a little bit. But I kind of want to mix it up a little bit and kind of create my own logo and put it on there and whatnot. Nothing but green for miles. Oh, that is bloody awesome. I don't know, but if Creech Bomb's actually watching this, man, you did a freaking awesome job on this sound mod. I think this is some of his best work so far. Some traffic is. I like that sound it makes when I kind of stick my head out the window there. That must have been going over some bumps or something and triggered some cab sound or something. Either way, pretty cool. Four-way's on this time to hopefully avoid any issues, and luckily nothing was coming, but get her and get her wound back up. As you can see how close we are here real quick. We're about halfway, so that's not too shabby. Not too shabby at all. Yeah, I definitely think the combination of the Sound Fixes pack and Creech Bomb's latest engine sound pack here, definitely good stuff. Kind of freshens things up a little bit. Makes it feel a little bit more realistic. So I keep checking the mini map there for like a rest area or something like that, but I'm not seeing anything yet. Coming up here. Let's go ahead and check something out real quick. I really couldn't tell. Maybe I'll have to go in the options, see if I have it turned on or not. I was just checking to see what the rumble strip sounded like. I know in some earlier editions of this mod, it sounded really cool. Here, the fuel mileage is going back up. I'd like to bump it up about another mile, get it about 6.3, 6.5. I think I'd be pretty happy with that. I guess I got probably pretty long ways to go yet before I hit that exit. I don't know if they've made any changes to the HUD there, but it seems like it's a little bit more user-friendly now, I guess. I don't know. Yeah, not too bad there. Well, guys, I think that is going to wrap it up for this episode of Stories from the Road. Hope that you guys enjoyed it. If you do, just give it a like and a share. This helps me out a bunch and helps the channel grow. And if you're new to the channel and are not already subscribed, please take a look around, watch a couple videos, consider subscribing now. But guys, until the next video, stay safe out there, take care, and we'll be seeing you.